What's good? Welcome back to the Loophole channel. In today's video, I'm going to be breaking down the main sound that I made for the song Girls Want Girls by Drake.
I might come, I might go, I don't know.
So the preset's from the first Loophole bank that we put out. It's a preset called Like Usual. The preset actually has a bit of a story behind it, and it was a massive full circle moment, I guess, when the song did come out with Drake. I named it Like Usual after, you know, working on The Weeknd, Like Usual, the main line from Life Is Good by Drake and Future, because I made the preset to sound like the main sound from that, which was produced by Ambezza and Ozzy. And then it just so happens that the song that comes out using it was also produced by Ambezza and Ozzy for Drake. So it was a massive kind of full circle moment for that. So the MIDI is really simple. I'll link another video on YouTube that breaks down the whole song, but this is specifically focused on this one sound and how it was made. So you can see when I pull up the preset, it was made in the CS80, which is actually one of the most complicated synths you can use in the whole Arteria collection. It's really unnecessarily complicated, but it does create an amazing sound. You can see here in the mix, I'm only using one of the oscillators. There's two oscillators here, but I'm just using the second one. The first one sounds like this. Which is a crazy sound in itself, but I think I made this and then decided against using it. So it's just 100% on this side, and it's just using a sine wave. That's all it is. And then the sine wave has added effects on it down here with the tremolo and the delay. So without the tremolo or delay, it sounds like this. So it's a little bit boring without the effects, but let's try and recreate this sound then. So let's copy and paste the MIDI. And then we're starting off with this sound. So very, very buzzy and bright. We only used one of the oscillators, so let's just pull it to just number one. Let's turn off this sawtooth wave, so now we're getting no sound. And let's pull up a sine wave here. So now we're getting this sound. So there's two main differences between the sine sound that we heard before and this sine sound. So one is that this is very deep. So let's pull it up an octave. So just put that up an octave, we hear this. Now that's a bit louder than it was before. So let's pull it down to maybe here. And then also the envelope is different. So in the original sound, it fades in and then drops out. And we want that to do the same instead of just coming in and then suddenly disappearing. So it's like a gate with this one. So we want to fade it in. So let's pull up the attack to maybe around here. And then what we want to do is pull the sustain down to nothing, because in the original sound, the sound just drops down to silence. So sustain down to nothing, decay up to, I think it was just above a second. It's about here, I think. So then we're getting this sound. Now the only last difference in terms of the volume is the release. So this is cutting out suddenly where we want it to fade out instead. So let's pull up the release to maybe half a second or just below half a second, like 300 works. And then we've almost got our sound there. All we want to do now is add some delay and some tremolo. So let's add some tremolo. So that's happening way too fast and I'm not hearing enough of it. So I want to turn up the depth and drop down the speed. So I'm going to drop down the speed to about half a second instead of this quick. So hertz just means number of times in a second. So I'm just going to pull it up to about here. That's good enough. And then pull up the depth a bit more. So then we get this sound. So now we've got a sound that's much more reminiscent of what we heard in the actual track. Compare that to... Now the only difference between this sound and the sound in the actual song is the delay. So we need to turn it up in the mix to just under halfway, I think. And then it was like this, I'm pretty sure it was tempo synced in terms of its speed. We just want to turn it down in the depth to be around here. So now we've got the final sound. So shout out Embeza for using that. That was a crazy moment. Quite often in my course, I talk about creating an interesting sound before you've added any effects. But this is a good example of a sound that just works because of its simplicity and how atmospheric it is. But yeah, I hope this preset breakdown was helpful in getting you to understand how that sound was made and how you can maybe create a similar sound in your own workflow. If it was helpful, it would be amazing if you could subscribe and like the video. Also, let us know what you'd like to see in the future in the comments below. But yeah, I'll see you in the next video. Girls want girls where I'm from. Play a player, baby. I grew up with Dre and FaZe. I done see the realest one.